Welcome. Today we are going to learn how to do Kegels and reverse Kegels well while coordinating with breath. Step 1 is to take a deep breath in, inhale. Relax your core or TA and relax your pelvic floor, opening up your vaginal and anal openings and creating space in your sit bones. Then we move on to closing or tightening our openings, our anal opening, vaginal opening, urinary opening, and pulling upwards with the core contraction, and exhale. So this was a little much to process for a lot of people, I'm sure. So let's take that again slowly. You can try various positions. All fours and kneeling are good, or you can do it sitting on a firm surface. Let's try that again. Take a deep breath in, feel the air filling your core, relaxing your belly muscles, going down into your pelvic floor and opening and creating space. We visualize our pelvic floor as a flower, widening and relaxing with the reverse Kegel, and closing and pulling up as we do our Kegel, tightening and closing our openings. Another example is to visualize a jellyfish in your core, with your inhale pushing the jellyfish down and its tentacles spreading and opening as you practice your reverse Kegel. The jellyfish then brings its tentacles together, which correlates to the closing of our openings, and the jellyfish begins to rise, which correlates to pulling our pelvic floor up as we do our Kegel. So there you have it. I have walked you through two contractions of the pelvic floor, the Kegel and the reverse Kegel, both of which are equally important for good pelvic health. The Kegel is a closing off and pulling in. The reverse Kegel is an opening up and relaxing outwards and downwards. Also remember, Kegels are just one tool in the arsenal of a pelvic floor therapist. If you have concerns with bladder leakage, constipation and bowel issues, painful intimacy, reach out for lasting help. Concierge Pelvic Floor is here to help you achieve good pelvic health in the comfort and convenience of your home. As always, with you, this is Sujata Martin.